DAFI program was started in 1992 and it's funded by the German government. And it is named after Albert Einstein. The main reason why it was set up was to address the challenge of tertiary education. We have set out collaboration and understanding with four public universities under this program: Jomo Kenyatta University of Agriculture and Technology, Kenyatta University, Moi University, and Masinde Muliro University. Ordinarily, a student who does not bear a Kenyan nationality is charged 20% more in tuition fees. Because we are serving a special category of people, our persons of concern, the refugees, who do not necessarily have money to fund their education. They are relying on scholarships such as DAFI. With these universities, we've been able to negotiate and agree that of the students sponsored in this program, they will not be levied the 20%.
Essentially, one of the things is to ensure that our students get a quick admission to these particular universities.
And we have MOUs operational since the end of 2014. We have operational MOUs with the four public universities.
The refugee students at some times were being charged as foreign students, and therefore through these MOUs, the students are now charged as Kenyans.
Other universities like University of Nairobi, they still admit our students, and we still manage to negotiate that they are not charged the 20% tuition on foreign students, though we have not necessarily penned down an MOU.
The inspiration statement of DAFI, which is Education Transforms Society, that agrees very well with the mission of our university, which says that we intend to provide leadership in the programs that we expose the students to. We also appreciate that we are training people to go and work in the society, and this society is dynamic.
Kenyatta University has been responsive to the situation of refugees in Kenya. First of all, we started by doing some research in Dadaab and established a campus. And majority of our students are refugees. Currently, we have 60 students who are studying in Kenyatta University under the scholarship of the DAFI program.
We have a partnership agreement with the Window Trust International and the UNHCR for supporting these DAFI scholars. We give them priority in terms of accommodation, and also because these students are international students, we don't charge them the international students fee.
Moi University is creating opportunities for refugee education, which is in line with the mission of Moi University, that opening up education for all. Even as we look at issues about the Sustainable Development Goals number 4, it's about creating education for all.
We do not separate those students who come in under program self-sponsored or scholarship from the ones that are given by government. So they all sit in the same classroom. When they go out to the communities, they are never labeled as international, foreign, or they are all Moi University.
The students who are in Dadaab and also those who are here under the DAFI scholarship program have a story to tell of success from their seniors who have been in Kenyatta University and gone out successfully with their degrees, diplomas, and sometimes certificates.
Window International, who are the implementing agency for UNHCR, they have helped these students because many times they come and give guidance to the students. They monitor their progress academically. If any student has a problem, it's social, they also come to support these students. UNHCR, in cooperation with the Window International, that we even come and participated in the graduation ceremonies of these students to give them their moral support.
We need to forge closer collaboration with the administrators of the scholarships and the institution particularly through the resident coordinators who are on the ground, to ensure that the almanac of the university doesn't disadvantage the students who are sponsored.
As we look at moving forward, we are wishing that the collaboration that we already have between Moi University, Windhoek Trust and UNITR can continue so that they can be able to get education, go back to their countries and rebuild. Then we can minimize incidences of conflict and civil strife.
Education is one of the most powerful tools to transform societies. Education is the greatest equalizer. Once you achieve a good education, then you can dine with even the kings.